गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू द इंग्लिश क्लास. ऑल ऑफ यू ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 114. सो टुडे लेट अस लर्न आवर न्यू लेसन यूनिट 10 द टच. सो दिस प्री रीडिंग टास्क इज फॉर योर होमवर्क चिल्ड्रन. राइट इट इन योर होमवर्क नोटबुक. So, before going through the lesson, let us see about the author who has written this lesson. So, this lesson, it is translated by Jayashri Mohan Raj. So, let us know about the author. This story is a translation by Jayashri Mohan Raj. Jayashri Mohan Raj has translated this story of Aburi Chaya Devi's short story Sparsha in Telugu. So, Aburi Chaya Devi has written a short story named Sparsha in Telugu. This story, the lesson is a story, and this story it is translated by Jayashri Mohan Raj. Aburi Chaya Devi is hailed as one of the earliest feminist writers in Telugu. She is one of the praised writers who used to write about the equality of women in Telugu, of women in Telugu. Her family, Aburi Chaya Devi's family, was extremely orthodox, means they were extremely traditional, and she took to writing as a means of self-expression. So she selected writing to express her own feelings. So in 2005, she won the Sahitya Academy Award. So the touch, in this story also she describes about the feelings of a daughter and a father. A father, during his young days, in the name of Madi or in the orthodox manner, he didn't touch his daughter nor he showed his love towards his daughter. But as he grew old, and when he was above 80, he wanted his daughter to sit near him, and he showered his love, he showed his love towards his daughter at the age of 80. So the daughter, still with hesitation, she sits near her father, though he asks her to sit beside him. So in this lesson, the feelings of the author and her father, it is explained very beautifully. So let us go through the lesson now. When I arrived, I found father lying on the string cot facing the wall. I had left my slippers outside the threshold, so my footsteps did not give away my presence. I went right up to the cot and asked, "Are you asleep?" "Who is it?" he asked as he turned on his side. So when the author went to her house, she found that her father was sleeping on a string cot, and he was looking at the wall. As the author had left her slippers at the point of entry of the house, threshold means point of entry, okay, point of entry of the house, so her father could not recognize her footsteps. He did not make out that somebody was coming near him. The author went near the cot and asked her father whether he was asleep. At that time, he turned and asked who was it. "It's I replied. "Come, sit here," he said, continuing to lie stretched out. When he heard me pulling the steel chair and preparing to sit down, he asked, "Why do you want to sit so far away? Come and sit close to me." He sat up to make space for me, showing the place on the cot next to him. When her father asked who was it, she replied that it's I. Then her father recognized and told her to. He continued to sleep, but he told her to come and sit. When the author pulled the steel chair to sit, her father asked her, "Why do you want to sit so far?" And he made some space beside him and asked her to sit next to him. I sat on the edge of the cot, groping. Father patted me on my back, and then he felt the place next to him on the cot and said, "Sit comfortably, Amma." I shifted a little, making myself comfortable. He groped in the air in front of him, gripped my hand, held it in both of his hands, and said, "I have been looking forward to your visit. Is everyone all right?" So, as the author's father asked her to sit, she sat on the edge of the cot. Groping means searching blindly. Okay, he searched blindly and he patted at the back of the author. Means the author's father was unable to see clearly. As he was aged, his eyesight were not proper. And later he felt that there is some place beside him and asked the author to sit comfortably beside him. So once again he searched in the air and he took the author's hand and holded it in both of his hands. And he said he had been looking forward to her to visit him, to see him. And he will ask that whether everyone is all right. "Yes," I said softly. He didn't say anything else and silently stroked my hand. So the author said that yes, everyone were all right. Everyone were well. And what he did, he didn't speak anything and he silently touched the author's hand. Once as a teenager, we had to go somewhere in a rickshaw. Though the rickshaw was spacious, I sat huddled at the far end. "Sit properly, Amma, you will fall off," father had said. I had hesitated and moved just an inch closer to him. From the time I learned my first letters of the alphabet, father had kept me at a distance. In the name of discipline, and because of Muddy, his orthodox way of life, I never had the courage to touch him. I had always felt that he was in a state of ritual purity. I was used to slipping into my cocoon. So, how could I ever think of sitting close to him in the rickshaw, our bodies touching? So here in this paragraph, the author remembers her childhood days. when she was a teenager, her father and the author had to go somewhere in a rickshaw. Though the rickshaw was spacious, though the rickshaw had enough space to sit, but the author had just moved and she had sat at the end of the rickshaw. So her father asked her to sit properly and he told her, otherwise you will fall off from the rickshaw. So here the author, she tells that from the first itself, when she learnt to speak, her father had kept her away in the name of discipline or in the name of muddy, his orthodox way of life. Because of his traditional way of life, he had kept his daughter far away from him. So the author didn't had the courage. So the author was not brave enough to touch her father. So she always felt that her father was in a state of ritual purity. She thought that he will follow the rituals, dharma charane. Okay. I was used to slipping into my cocoon. So always whenever she saw her father, she went somewhere to protect herself. So how could I ever think of sitting close to him in the rickshaw, our bodies touching? So she never thought of sitting near her father with both of their bodies touching. When children return from school, if you embrace them lovingly and speak to them in a friendly way, they open up and chirp like happy birds. Instead, if they are greeted harshly at the threshold with "How much did you score in maths?" or "Have you brought your report card?" they die of fright. I died many such deaths over some 20 years. I still haven't got over the diffidence they created. So, always when the children come to home after school, parents, they have to treat them in a friendly way. They have to speak them lovingly. At that time only, children, they open up. They share each and every feelings with the parents. Or else, if you are very strict and if you ask about the marks or If you ask about the marks or report card, they will die of fright. And also, the author had died many such frightens for 20 years. It means her father was very strict. So, still now, she didn't overcome that diffidence. Still she has that lack of confidence. So still she is a lack of confidence about her. Means she is not confident about her. Father is over 18 now. Past the age of recovering his sight, even if his eyes were to be operated upon. Though he is otherwise healthy, his poor eyesight has made him weak. He has spent the last 2 years in bed. My husband and I had come to town on hearing that my mother-in-law was not well to spend some time with her. I managed to visit my parents once in a while as they live in a same town. On such visits, I used to spend about half an hour chatting with father. So, the author's father is about 80 years now. and he has passed his age of recovering. He has a poor eyesight which was operated before, but also though he is healthy, because of his poor eyesight he is bedridden. He always sleeps on the bed from the last 2 years. The author's husband and the author had come to visit her mother-in-law, as her mother-in-law was not well. Her mother-in-law and her parents' house both were in the same town. So she adjusted some time and she went to meet her parents. And whenever the author went to meet her parents, she used to talk with her father for about half an hour. To sit close to father is to revive a faint memory of childhood. When he took my hand into his hand and stroked it with love, the longing I had felt as a child for such a touch flooded my inner being and tears welled up in my eyes. I choked. I couldn't speak. Would he understand that I had once longed for his loving touch? Perhaps all the love and affection that had flowed between us in letters evaporated at his sharp, intense look whenever we came face to face. Even in early childhood, I used to avoid him to escape his piercing glance that had hurt like scorching sun rays. Now, though I knew that they had been extinguished, why was I still unable to feel free with him? So, when the author sat close to her father, all the faint memory, all the lost memory of her childhood came back. When her father took her hand into his hand and stroked, touched it with love, so she remembered that she had wished for the same love when she was young. And her eyes were filled with tears. She became speechless. She couldn't speak. And also she thinks that whether her father will understand that before, means at her younger days, at her childhood days, she wished for his loving touch. When the author was young, she always wished for his loving touch, but her father, in the name of discipline and in the name of muddy, he kept her far. Now, as the father is aged, now he is showing love and affection towards her, towards his daughter. So the author thinks that whether he can understand that she also had wished for his loving touch in her childhood days. So when she wished for love and affection in childhood days, so because of his sharp, intense look, because of his angry look, and because of his harsh look, which had hurt her like hot sun rays when they came face to face, she never went to her father. Now, though she knew that those old days are wiped out or went away, still she is not able to feel free with her father. Still, she is not feeling comfortable to sit beside her father and टू शेयर हर फीलिंग्स बिकॉज इन हर चाइल्डहुड ऑलवेज वॉट हर फादर यूज टू डू हर फादर यूज टू लुक एट हर विथ अ शार्प इंटेंस एंड दैट ग्लांस दैट लुक हर फादर्स लुक वॉज लाइक स्कॉर्चिंग हॉट सन रेज बिकॉज ऑफ दैट शी वॉज वेरी स्केर्ड ऑफ हर फादर एंड शी वॉज ऑलवेज सिटिंग अवे फ्रॉम हर father so now also that scaredness was in her so she was not feeling to sit freely with her father I hope you have understood the remaining part we'll continue in our next class thank you children